Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Shadi Aqil. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa on the occasion of returning to Bahrain after visiting Qatar, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa on the occasion of returning to Bahrain after visiting Kuwait, during which they had met separately with the Emir of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, and the Emir of Qatar, His Highness Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani. Their Royal Highnesses briefed His Majesty the King on the positive outcomes that resulted from their visits that will benefit Bahrain, Kuwait, and Qatar. His Majesty praised these results that serve the relations between the three countries towards further joint cooperation and integration that support the GCC March, as well as its achievements and gains made to the countries and their people. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace Housing Minister Bassem bin Ya'qub Al Hamar and a number of the ministry's affiliates. The meeting was also attended by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Majesty the King then greeted the minister and the ministry's affiliates and expressed his pleasure in meeting with them. Thank you.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه، سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير خليفة بن سلمان آل خليفة رئيس الوزراء الموقر حفظه الله ورعاه، سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد نائب القائد الأعلى النائب الأول لرئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله ورعاه، أصحاب السمو، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها الضيوف الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. نرحب بكم في هذا اللقاء الذي يتفضل فيه سيدي جلالة الملك المفدى باستقبال سعادة وزير الإسكان وكبار المسؤولين في الوزارة. وخير البداية تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا المقرئ عمر
محمد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين. وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء فنعم أجر العاملين. وترى الملائكة حافين من حول العرش يسبحون بحمد ربهم وقضي بينهم بالحق وقيل الحمد لله رب العالمين. صدق الله العظيم.
He commended the sincere efforts of the Ministry of Housing and the application of Bahrain policies in the field of allocating social housings and its continuous commitment over four decades in delivering and upgrading its housing services in the aim of providing a decent livelihood for Bahraini families. He also extended his thanks to the Ministry for their ongoing attempts in reducing the citizens' waiting list through diversifying housing options and providing multiple solutions, most notably involving the private sector and encouraging it to contribute to the urban development and construction of modern cities. His Majesty affirmed that the development of the social housing sector shall remain at the center of the Bahraini government's interest, which is evident in the ambitious plans and projects that aim towards urban sustainable development that are in part in line with international standards. The Housing Minister delivered a speech in which he expressed his thanks and appreciation to the leadership for their keen interest in the social housing issues that undoubtedly contributed to maximizing efforts that aim to achieve His Majesty's vision of providing the best housing services to the citizens in the shortest span of time. Mr. Al-Hamar stated that His Majesty's directives of making humanitarian cases a priority comes at the forefront of the Ministry's current strategy. He also stated that the housing sector is witnessing developments in executing new cities' plans as well as housing complexes in all governorates of Bahrain. The Housing Minister assented that this development is the result of the continuous achievements made over the past 50 years in providing housing services to the citizens, which began in the 60s of the past century. He concluded by expressing his honor in meeting His Majesty the King, emphasizing that such meetings would provide the ministry affiliates with more determination in resolving the social housing issues in spite of its complex nature.
والتي تحظى برعاية كريمة ومستمرة من قبل الديوان الملكي، وما تبع ذلك من توجيهاتكم السديدة بالإسراع في توزيع هذه الوحدات المستحقيها هو عنوان المرحلة الإسكانية الحالية، حيث إنه وبعد صدور أمر جلالتكم وبفضل من المولى عز وجل يشهد الملف الإسكاني تطوراً كبيراً، سواء على صعيد تنفيذ مشاريع مدن البحرين الجديدة ومشاريع المجمعات السكنية في جميع محافظات ومدن وقرى المملكة، وتطوراً في حجم التوزيعات الإسكانية التي تقوم الوزارة بتنفيذها، فضلاً عن التقدم الكبير الذي تم إنجازه على صعيد الشراكة مع القطاع الخاص. وما هذا التطور يا صاحب الجلالة إلا شاهداً على استمرار عجلة الإنجازات التي تحققت على مدار ما يقارب نصف قرن من تقديم الخدمات الإسكانية للمواطنين، والتي بدأت منذ ستينيات القرن الماضي، وشهدت تقديم أكثر من 125,000 خدمة إسكانية لمواطني المملكة حتى منتصف العقد الحالي. كل ذلك ترجمة واضحة للرؤية المستقبلية للقيادة الرشيدة منذ ذلك الوقت وحتى عهدكم الزاهر، نحو مجتمعات مستدامة تحظى بكافة الخدمات الأساسية والمرافق. فكان نموذ مشروع مدينة عيسى هو النواة الأولى لهذه الرؤية، تلاه بعد ذلك مشروع مدينة حمد في حقبة الثمانينيات، ثم مدينة زايد في فترة التسعينيات، لتتلاحق الإنجازات لحلحلة الملف الإسكاني. وما مشروع المدينة الشمالية ومشروع شرق الحد ومدينة شرق سترة وإسكان المحافظة الجنوبية وإسكان الرملي إلا شاهداً على ذلك، وما سبق ذكره من مشاريع ما هو إلا حجر الزاوية في خطة الوزارة وبرامجها الرامية إلى تنفيذ أمر جلالتكم السامي. سيدي صاحب الجلالة، إن الملف الإسكاني ومنذ عام 2011 يشهد ولله الحمد ازدهاراً ونمواً بفضل الرعاية الملكية، وما يمثل حقبة جديدة في تاريخ الإسكان بالمملكة، فلقد تم تنفيذ أكثر من 17,000 وحدة سكنية في جميع المحافظات والقرى، وذلك منذ صدور أمر جلالتكم السامي عام 2013 لسد الاحتياجات الإسكانية، حيث تتنوع نسب الإنجاز بها إلى مشاريع مكتملة وأخرى قيد التنفيذ وأخرى سيتم الشروع في تنفيذها قريباً، فيما تم وبحمد الله توزيع أكثر من 9,000 وحدة سكنية خلال هذه الفترة. كما شهد الملف الإسكاني صاحب الجلالة تفعيل أولى مبادرات الشراكة مع القطاع الخاص لتنفيذ مشاريع إسكانية في المدينة الشمالية ومنطقة اللوزي، بالإضافة إلى تدشين برنامج مزايا، فضلاً عن إطلاق مشروع ديرة العيون بديار المحرك، وهي مبادرات استطاعت أن تحقق تقدماً كبيراً مكملة لجهود الحكومة الموقرة الهادفة إلى تحقيق تطلعات ورؤى جلالتكم. وختاماً، إن شرف مقابلتكم لنا يا صاحب الجلالة يمنحنا بمشيئة الله مزيداً من العزم والإصرار رغم طبيعة الملف الإسكاني بظروفه الحالية، متطلعين إلى كرم جلالتكم بما عهدنا من رعاية سامية وتوجيه ودعم، فلكم منا يا صاحب الجلالة عظيم الشكر والعرفان، سائلين المولى أن يحفظكم ويحفظ مملكتنا الحبيبة ويسدد على طريق الخير خطاكم، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Al-Hamar then presented His Majesty with a commemorative gift. His Majesty the King held a lunch banquet in honor of the ministry's affiliates. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a telephone call from the Foreign Minister of the United States, Rex Tillerson. His Majesty affirmed the bilateral deep historic relations and expressed his aspiration to further enhance these relations and to maintain the security and stability of the region. He praised the role of the U.S. President Donald Trump in developing these relations with Bahrain and the region, wishing the U.S. and its people further progress and prosperity. The U.S. Foreign Minister expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty's services provided to the Fifth Fleet to facilitate their task in maintaining security and stability of the region. He affirmed that Bahrain plays a vital role in maintaining security and stability of the region. He praised the openness of the kingdom and the progress witnessed in all fields, expressing aspiration for more joint action in various fields, especially in security, stability, and combating terrorism. He wished His Majesty abundant health in the Kingdom of Bahrain and its people, further progress and prosperity. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa departed from Qatar today after concluding an official visit. During the visit, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister held a meeting with the Father Emir, His Highness Sheikh Hamad bin Khalifa Al Thani, to discuss ways to further develop bilateral relations. His Royal Highness was seen off by Qatar's Prime Minister and Minister of Interior, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Nasser Al Thani. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister sent a cable of appreciation to the Emir of Qatar, His Highness Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani, in which he expressed thanks and appreciation for the hospitality he received during the official visit to Qatar, which reflects the deep-rooted Bahraini-Qatari relations. He stated that the visit will enhance coordination and cooperation on the Gulf and Arab levels. His Royal Highness hailed the development of Qatar under the leadership of His Highness Sheikh Tamim, wishing him abundant health and success and Qatar further development and prosperity. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister sent a similar cable to the Father Emir, His Highness Sheikh Hamad bin Khalifa Al Thani, in which he expressed thanks and appreciation for the hospitality he received during the official visit to Qatar, which reflects the deep-rooted Bahraini-Qatari relations. His Royal Highness highlighted the friendly relations between the people of the two countries. He also hailed the development of Qatar under the leadership of His Highness Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister wished His Highness Sheikh Hamad abundant health and success and Qatar further development and prosperity. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister sent another cable of appreciation to the personal representative of His Highness the Emir of Qatar, Sheikh Jassim bin Hamad Al Thani, in which he expressed thanks and appreciation for the hospitality he received during the official visit to Qatar, which reflects the deep-rooted Bahraini-Qatari relations. His Royal Highness stated that the visit will develop coordination and cooperation between the two countries in various fields. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister sent a cable to Qatar's Prime Minister and Minister of Interior, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Nasser Al Thani, in which he expressed thanks and appreciation for the hospitality he received during the official visit to Qatar, which reflects the deep-rooted Bahraini-Qatari relations. His Royal Highness noted the Qatari Prime Minister's keenness in developing cooperation between the two countries for the benefit of their friendly people. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received earlier today at his residence in the Qatari capital Doha the personal representative of the Emir of Qatar, Sheikh Jassim bin Hamad Al Thani. His Royal Highness expressed pleasure in visiting Qatar, which forms an occasion to discuss methods of developing the historic relations between the two countries. He stressed that the Bahraini-Qatari relations witness a continuous development that embodies their interest in enhancing cooperation in various sectors. During the meeting, the two parties discussed the outstanding brotherly relations and methods of developing cooperation. For his part, Sheikh Jassim hailed His Royal Highness's visit, affirming that it will enhance cooperation between the two countries. He commended His Royal Highness's efforts in developing cooperation between the Gulf Cooperation Council countries, which proves his wise vision and leadership that supports integration between them, praising his role in the development that the kingdom witnesses in various fields. Thank you. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received earlier today at his residence in the Qatari capital Doha. The Prime Minister and the Minister of Interior of Qatar, Sheikh Abdullah bin Nasser Al Thani. During the meeting, the two parties reviewed the brotherly relations between the two countries and the methods of enhancing them in the economic and development fields. His Royal Highness and his Qatari counterpart affirmed that the solid ties between the two countries form a model of effective cooperation based on deep-rooted historic foundations. They also expressed keenness on developing bilateral cooperation and coordination. His Royal Highness expressed pleasure in visiting Qatar and the fruitful talks held with the Qatari leadership, expressing thanks and appreciation for the warm welcome he received, which represents the solid ties between the two countries. He hailed the development of bilateral ties which stem from the mutual keenness on enhancing cooperation. For his part, the Qatari Prime Minister welcomed His Royal Highness to Qatar, commending His Royal Highness's role in enhancing cooperation between the two countries and his efforts in developing joint Gulf work. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received earlier today at his residence in the Qatari capital of Doha the Qatari Shura Council Chairman Mohammed bin Barak Al Khalifi. During the meeting, the two parties discussed methods of cooperation between the two countries. His Royal Highness hailed the development of Bahraini-Qatari relations that embodies the two countries' keenness on developing cooperation. He noted the importance of enhancing cooperation based on a unified goal and destiny. He highlighted the role of legislatures and the Gulf Cooperation Council countries in supporting the efforts of comprehensive development and enhancing their ability in facing various economic, political, and security challenges in the region. He also noted that his visit provided an opportunity for him to meet the Qatari leadership and discuss bilateral relations, stressing the importance of increasing visits and meetings between senior officials in the two countries to enhance cooperation. For his part, the Qatari Shura Council Chairman expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness for his support to developing bilateral relations, affirming that the visit embodies the deep-rooted historic relations between the two countries. He also commended His Royal Highness's wise vision and wise expertise that contributed to the development of Bahrain and to the support of the Joint Gulf March in various fields. On the sidelines of the official visit to Qatar, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa visited Waqf Souq and toured its facilities that represent a combination of tradition and modernity. His Royal Highness expressed admiration of the souq, which reflects the development of Qatar under the leadership of His Highness the Emir of Qatar, Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani. His Royal Highness also noted that Waqf Souq is an example of historical and traditional sites that are used for touristic purposes, adding that Bahrain and Qatar are keen on promoting heritage to support tourism. Thank you. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa today departed to Bahrain after concluding an official visit to Kuwait. The official visit provided an opportunity for His Royal Highness the Crown Prince to meet the Kuwaiti leadership and discuss bilateral relations, regional issues of interest, and ways to advance bilateral cooperation across a wide range of areas. His Highness the Crown Prince of Kuwait, Sheikh Nawaf Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, Kuwait's National Assembly Speaker Marzouk Ali Al Ghanem, Prime Minister of Kuwait Sheikh Jaber Al Mubarak Al Hamad Al Sabah, the ambassadors of both countries, and a number of senior Kuwaiti officials attended the departure ceremony. During the official visit, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince was accompanied by the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, the President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and a number of senior Bahraini ministers and officials. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince sent a cable of appreciation to the Emir of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, in which he expressed thanks and appreciation to His Highness the Emir of Kuwait for the hospitality he and his accompanying delegation received during the visit to Kuwait. His Royal Highness praised the cooperation between Bahrain and Kuwait and their developing relations under the support of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and His Highness Sheikh Sabah. He also noted the efforts exerted to strengthen the integration of the GCC for the benefit of all people. His Royal Highness also praised the role of Kuwait in supporting Arab solidarity and defending Arab and Islamic issues. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince also wished His Highness the Emir of Kuwait abundant health and success, and the people of Kuwait further success and prosperity. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince sent a similar cable to the Crown Prince of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Nawaf Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, in which he expressed thanks and appreciation for the hospitality he and his accompanying delegation received during the official visit to Kuwait. His Royal Highness hailed the meeting he had previously held with His Highness the Crown Prince of Kuwait, which affirmed the keenness of both parties to develop coordination and cooperation between the two countries in various fields. His Royal Highness wished his counterpart further success and Kuwait further development. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince sent a similar cable to the Prime Minister of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Jaber Al Mubarak Al Hamad Al Sabah, in which he expressed thanks and appreciation for the hospitality he and his accompanying delegation received during the official visit to Kuwait. His Royal Highness noted the Kuwaiti Prime Minister's keenness in developing Bahraini-Kuwaiti relations in all fields. He wished the Kuwaiti Prime Minister success and Kuwait further development. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier, attended yesterday a dinner banquet hosted by Kuwait's Prime Minister, Sheikh Jaber Al Mubarak Al Hamad Al Sabah, in honor of His Royal Highness and his accompanying delegation at Abraj Al Kuwait. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince praised the developing brotherly relations, cooperation and coordination between Bahrain and Kuwait. His Royal Highness also noted the honorable stances between the two countries in all circumstances. His Royal Highness said that the keen interest of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the Emir of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, to enhance the historic bilateral ties founded by the forefathers. The two sides lauded the solid historic relations linking Bahrain and Kuwait that created wider horizons for joint work and further cooperation and coordination for the best interests of both countries and their people. The Crown Prince and the Prime Minister noted the successful partnerships between both countries across wide-ranging sectors, reaffirming the importance of building on existing partnerships, particularly in economic and development-related areas. The dinner banquet was attended by His Majesty the King's representative for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, President of the Supreme Council of Youth and Sports, and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, in addition to the official delegation accompanying His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, ministers and senior officials representing the Kuwaiti side were also present. The representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, the Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, congratulated the Al Ahli Club team for achieving the first positions in the Arab Club's Volleyball Championship. His Highness pointed out that this achievement is evidence of the significant development the Bahraini sports scene is witnessing due to the care it receives from the leadership and their constant efforts in providing suitable circumstances for the clubs to elevate their competition skills, which would reflect positively on Bahrain's status in the international sports arena. He also added that this achievement is a result of the professionalism of the club's board members that work diligently to provide the suitable atmosphere for the team to achieve the title, in addition to the team members who showcase their high skills and enthusiasm to represent the Kingdom of Bahrain. His Highness Sheikh Nasser affirmed that the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports is keen to support the Bahraini clubs in taking part in international competitions and the efforts of achieving similar results that would prove the significant development of the Bahraini sports. He also asserted the Council's backing of the clubs in order to advance all administrative and technical systems, which will ensure that the Bahraini sports achieve further gains. The first Deputy President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of the West Asian Athletics Federation and President of the Bahrain Athletics Association, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, congratulated the President and Council members of Al Ahli Club team for achieving the first position in the 35th Arab Club's Volleyball Championship. Al Ahli team defeated Al Jaish of Qatar team with a score of 3-2 rounds. His Highness stressed that they earned this victory after delivering an outstanding performance in this championship and achieved this accomplishment for the second time in the team's history of participations. He also stressed that Al Ahli's achievement in the championship reflects the development of volleyball due to the support from the wise leadership to the youth and sports sector, and the outstanding efforts of the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, of implementing strategies and programs that aim to raise the technical level of all sports with the goal of honorable participations and bringing more achievements for Bahraini sports in various gatherings. He praised the high technical performance of Al Ahli team in the final match and the strong performance of the players who managed to achieve the honorable results, which reflect the efforts of the club's council administrative and technical members in preparing the team and achieving a positive result. His Highness said that the final match was filled with excitement and power from both teams, but ended in favor of Al Ahli. His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa praised the Bahraini and Arab associations, headed by Ali bin Muhammad Al Khalifa, and all of the working committees for organizing this Arab gathering in the Kingdom of Bahrain, which showcased the event and turned it into a success. His Highness wished luck to the association in organizing upcoming championships that serve to raise the level of the sports to the level of Arab nations. The Interior Minister, Lieutenant General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, the Chief of Public Security, Major General Tariq Al Hassan, to attend a celebration organized by the General Directorate of Civil Defense on the occasion of World Civil Defense Day. Chief of Public Security affirmed that the ministry always follows up on recent updates and developments and stressed the importance of taking the necessary measures and preparations to face all current and future challenges. He pointed out the minister's directives to prepare a new strategic project to develop and the civil defense body for the next phase. He stressed the importance of the humanitarian message of the civil defense and highlighted the progress witnessed in Bahrain in all fields, which requires total readiness and high professionalism in order to support the progress. He added that the General Directorate of Civil Defense has a main role in deterring riots, sabotage, and terrorism, and in supporting the efforts of the National Disaster Management Committee and coordinating efforts between ministries and organizations. He explained that the civil defense members have always faced climate variability and natural phenomenon disasters, noting that on this day, the world recalls the sacrifices of the civil defense members and their role in protecting lives and possessions. The Director General of Civil Defense held the support of the Interior Minister and his follow-up with the Chief of Public Security, noting that this support contributed to the development of the Directorate on the level of mechanisms and cadres. He added that the Directorate had developed the level of performance and involved a number of national sectors to enhance partnership between various authorities. The ceremony included the honoring of a number of officers and members of the civil defense and a number of the Directorate's partners from industrial companies.